Portland has three timeouts left. The Lakers have two. Bryant to Shaq!
Don't believe the hype.
Same thing, it's a new thing. Check out this, I bring all the roll below the level, cause I'm living low next to the base.
Come on,
turn up the radio. They're claiming I'm a criminal.
And now Harper, looking for Shaq, who takes it in deep. And you can't stop that.
Manning the same following the timeout. Here's Grant. O'Neal. And Shaq puts it down. Facial shows up on the tumble.
The Lakers love to get to those offensive.
Hey, this is decision back at the hotel at the beach today. I'm shooting every time I touch it.
By Shaquille O'Neal.
Throw it down, big man. Throw it down.
Don't believe the hype.
Yes, was the start of my last jam. So here it is again, another death jam. But since I gave you all a little something that I knew you lacked, they still consider me a new jack. All the critics you can hang on my hold the rope, but they hope to the Pope and pray it ain't dope. The follower of Farrakhan, he'll tell me.
And two mobile able to spin away.
Again, the matchup. Rodman trying to defend against O'Neal. And the foul call. That's two on Rodman. Without Luke Longley, Phil Jackson loses the ability not only to have the big guy in the middle or another big guy, but it's more fouls to give at the center position. And of course, you don't mind putting Shaquille O'Neal at the free throw line. Bad pass, and on the turnover, here are the Bulls.
Well, Dennis Rodman giving up a lot of height, weight, and strength, trying to keep his hands out of there as the official, I'm sure, in that baseline telling him, watch your hands. And he did, and Shaq not taking advantage of.
Shaquille O'Neal was ejected, a season-low 7 points. Now let's go back to Chicago.
What a block by Russell! What a block by Bill Russell on Chamberlain's dunk shot! Incredible!
Russell is a master of psychology. At times, he'd let Wilt score so that the ball would keep going to Wilt and the rest of the guys never got involved. And then he'd shut Wilt down.
Thank you. No good. Chamberlain gets the ball. Up and there he goes. Erickson is on the opposite side as Chamberlain has the ball working on Reed now. He's probably trying to be mobile to make Reed move around. Instead passes it out. In defense of the Knicks. Chamberlain has the ball. Double team. Reed trying to work on him. And Chamberlain having trouble hitting. And it goes to Chamberlain.
And you see Walt Frazier is very aware as well. Loses the ball. What a sweet catch.
The halftime score is New York 69, Los Angeles 42.
The second half, unless he makes a quick appearance, there's the comparison between Wilt and Willis, and that does not certainly tell the story. Wilt has been great, 11 points, 12 rebounds, but the 12 rebounds would indicate what the point that we made, that the strength of Willis Reed has kept Wilt away from that board and has not allowed him to operate as freely as we saw him operate on Wednesday evening.
Loops one to Chamberlain. Chamberlain does it. Now it's 71 to 49. Garrett. Will Chamberlain.
One. We have a new NBA champion.
I've been watching Akeem Hall play off ball. I don't know what shot I would want him to take if I'm guarding him. Make the
O'Neal. Olajuwon for three. And back to Capitol.
Olajuwon with the jump hook. Go back to Dennis Rodman.
Since Rodman was late for practice yesterday, he's been the first one in attendance for every other meeting. First one to check.
One thing I could do was finger roll.
Back into the hotel, first one to the team meal, but I don't care how early you get there, nobody can deal with that. Face.
Because I don't respect any guys in the league that's been in this league for the last 2-3 years. I don't respect them because the guys here don't respect the game of basketball. They respect the money and the publicity and the stardom before anything. You know, the money's always got to be up front. You know, and they don't understand the reason why they're in this game is to provide entertainment and provide themselves self-esteem and confidence to move on. Mm-hmm. With the money there, they don't have to do anything anymore.
Set for the opening tip. Let's talk about what we expect in this game, Matt.
Well, Greg, Chicago wants to do what they do best, and that's play defense and create offense from that defense, get as many fast break baskets as they can, and they also want to get second shot opportunities behind Dennis Rodman, who does it so well. But the Magic big people also can do a very good job on the boards, and they
Bulls by 10, 7:50 to play.
Opened up all kinds of opportunities for Longley and Rodman.
Jackson did not want. There is a whistle before the shot. An illegal defense call against the Bulls.
Well, Dennis Rodman has had some success with playing Shaq. Even though Dennis only weighs about 218 pounds, he has a strong low base, able to push Shaq a little bit further out than he wants. No double team came there. If the double is going to come, it's going to come from the strong side of the floor, from the passer that enters into Shaq.
Mostly what Dennis Rodman has is a strong will. Put his body on the line against Shaq.
Three-pointer, no good. The rebound.
Now that is a rebound. A 7'2", 320 pound, whatever guy, moving up, or getting killed on the glass. So just one offensive rebound to the hoop.
Report from the sideline is that Penny Hardaway cut his leg. He is on the sideline now, but he is all right. O'Neal shot, no. Comes away with it.
Isn't it amazing what a good defensive job Dennis Rodman does? He has the strength somehow to make Shaq take a shot rather than get bulled to the basket.
For guys who can't shoot like Buschner and Kerr.
Horace Grant not looking for a shot, almost threw it away. And there's a foul called as Shaquille went into his move.
Horace can't create his own shot. Horace is a guy that Dennis Rodman is going to push and lean. Dennis was telling him yesterday, he'll do whatever it takes. He'll put his life on the line in guarding Shaquille O'Neal.
And looking to cut it down to single digits. Shaq calling for the ball. Rodman on him. Anderson for three.
Glass for Rodman, for Pippen, for Harper, for anybody.
Back down to Shaq. Rodman now goes to work on the defense against the field. His jump shot is good.
And they're not putting any pressure on him defensively with Nick Anderson not hitting his shots. Nobody from Orlando hitting from outside the paint.
Taken away from behind. Harper. The Bulls ever since to make sure that in particular Dennis Scott does not get off.
But this is the way the Bulls played the entire regular season. The ball movement spinning around, confusing the defense, and a great defense leading to easy opportunities.
Scott with the giveaway. Forced to put the ball on the floor, jumped in the air, turnover, layup.
Rodman, like Akeem, willing to get in there and put his body on Shaq.
Last three games in the New York series, he looks fresh.
His medication seems to be working just fine.
Shaq lost it. Dennis Rodman all over Shaquille O'Neal.
Michael Jordan stepping in the pass lane, never jumped to pass to throw a ball. Coming down, he finds Pippen. Got Jordan, Pippen, Kukoc, and Rodman coming at you on the break. You're in trouble. Luggage over there.
And Rodman grabs him and says, part of the game.
Well, Bill, you talked earlier.
Quick to apologize and calm Shaq down, too.
That's embarrassing, most of these
numbers. Rodman has as many rebounds as the Magic do as a team.
The crowd's starting to taunt Horace Grant here.
Horace Grant. Jim Gray is checking it out for us. We'll get a report from him as soon as possible. Shaq missed the dunk. Back Hardaway to Shaquille down the lane for the layup. So Shaq adds another two. He has 22. 90-67.
He's going to score on you. You really have problems.
Shaq down low, got fouled. He'll go to the line.
That thing.
Like that.
Oh boy.
Not like that.
Bulls 120. Chicago grabs a one-game lead.
Thank you very much, Ahmad. Dennis Rodman, 13 points today, 21 rebounds. Dennis, why such an offensive threat today?
Well, a lot of people count me out for a long, long time, and, it doesn't matter what I do, it's not right. But today, I guess I had the right chemistry, and too bad the Horace got hurt, but I think we had the game face on today. I think Orlando came in a little flat, so we caught him off guard.
Is the right chemistry for you being sick because you have a stomach virus? Didn't seem to bother you, did it?
Well, that doesn't matter, I've always said that if I can walk on my two feet, come out here and produce, it doesn't matter what's wrong with me. I'm coming out here to do my job.
Dennis, congratulations. Great game.
Thanks a lot. Hi, Alexis.
All right, let's go back to Greg Gumbel.
All right, Jim Gray.
And help out. Ryan Hill told us this morning at the other end, here's O'Neal, who is fouled by Longley. Puts a body on him. Now Pippen comes to help. Foul on Longley, that's two. Dennis Scott. Harper picks him up. Scott finds O'Neal. Jordan tries. Entry pass to O'Neal. Wennington puts a body on him. And Shaq over. Blazing way out. Rodman on O'Neal. Has forced 20 turnovers per game. Orlando with two tonight. O'Neal, no. Rodman was there for Chicago. Kukoc with the double team, and he picks up a cheap foul.
And I'm going to say this, a blind squirrel will find an acorn every now and then.
Guys ready to score tonight. Very embarrassed by game one performance, but there we have it again. Scottie Pippen going right by. But here at the other end, Scottie Pippen goes right around. Shaq comes over to help out Rodman for the easy lay-in.
Finds Pippen, who's posting up. O'Neal with a double team that leaves Rodman open.
That's terrible defense by Orlando. Rodman's the guy you want to leave open, but you can't give up the dunk. Rodman's like Shaq, not a good free throw shooter, at least fouling and making shoot free throws.
Rodman had 13 to go with his 21 rebounds on Sunday. Concat, good job defensively on Longley. Rodman with the offensive board is fouled, and he'll go to the line. O'Neal picked up the foul.
Beautiful work by Dennis Rodman again on the offensive glass. Sneaking inside of Shaq. Shaq's not a great box out guy. He just relies on his size and strength to get the rebounds. Right here, Shaq doesn't pay attention. Dennis slips right in.
O'Neal.
Well, it is ugly. Rodman seems to make him when he needs to, though. He's a...
Oh, dear. Here's Kerr, Longley. Nice cut. Good coach, here's Rodman. I keep thinking of Chuck Daly. Orlando's done a good job of protecting the ball tonight. Here's O'Neal over Rodman. Offensive board. Rodman comes out of there, finds Pippen. O'Neal gets it. Five in the shot clock. Rodman. And the rebound to Jordan. Here comes Scottie Pippen. Shaw's there.
Again, good defense by Orlando. Orlando sealing the play.
Are you kidding me?
Well, we see Shaq, who has absolutely no respect for Dennis's offensive game, is playing Dennis 2 feet from the basket when Dennis has the ball 8 feet away. Dennis making him pay all night.
With a jump shot. Rodman is now 5 of 7 from the field. He's got 12 points. Double comes from Pippen. That leaves Hardaway open. No. Jordan with another rebound.
Right here, Dennis Rodman showing his great acting talents. Gets hit in the face, but then watch the double pump, flop, going back. Good defense, though, by Dennis, causing Shaq to catch the ball way outside of the paint.
Rodman,
crowd is going crazy. Michael's got the hot hand. They got to find a way to score some points. It's a big possession.
O'Neal guarded by Rodman. Pippen with the double team, and the foul is called on Buschler. Out on the perimeter. Now tries to get his position. Rodman comes in front, makes the steal. Here's Randy Brown.
He was fouled by Penny Hardaway.
And again, that was good defense by Rodman fighting over the top of Shaq, but it was the pressure defense by Randy Brown. He was all over the ball. Pippen gives him a good bump, slows him down, going down to the block, but we can't see it there on the screen. But Randy Brown was all over Brian Shaw, couldn't see Dennis Rodman coming around the weak side.
Guarded by Shaw. Shaw guarded by Kerr, looks for O'Neal. Traveling. No, offensive foul on O'Neal.
You know, Dennis Rodman is playing very aggressive defense all over Shaq, pushing him, holding him, grabbing him, doing the deep playing defense the way he should. Shaq just tries to get Dennis off his arm and gets called for an offensive foul. Oh, there's no question, Vern. They've only scored 18 points, Orlando has, in the last 17 minutes of the game. And they've done a good job on Shaq. Shaq had some good spurts.
Shaw. Underneath, the dunk is good. 5.3. Scott. It's over. The Bulls are up 2-0. Michael Jordan with 17 in the third quarter.
Seven. Now single coverage on Shaquille. Goes at Longley. Rebound handled by Rodman. 5 minutes remaining in this opening quarter. Rodman. Dennis Rodman with his first field goal. Game is tied at 14. Shaquille.
Defensively, as far as coming down and double teaming Shaquille O'Neal, for the most part they're letting him go on one, but once he puts that second dribble down, if somebody can get there, and it's usually from
Jim Gray from the Orlando Arena. And Shaquille O'Neal is now 2 of 7, has the ball up front with Dennis Rodman and Bill Wennington, and Rodman being played by O'Neal. Shot clock at 4, and Rodman pops it home. Dennis Rodman looking for the outside shot these days. That's his second. And O'Neal hits the deck, takes Rodman with him. Rodman complaining that he was tripped up by O'Neal. I see a technical foul has been called. Steve Javy with the call against Shaquille.
And Dennis Rodman saying, he grabbed my foot and pulled me down. As Dennis Rodman did pick up the foul, as he was trying to back into Shaquille for the offensive rebound, knew he was beaten on the play. Dennis knocking it loose, and now here's where he fouls Shaquille, and then Shaquille does grab the right leg in the ankle area of Dennis Rodman, and that's why he called for the technical foul.
Here the reaction from the crowd. Facing Longley to punch with 6 points. Difficulties. O'Neal not able to hit and rebounded by Rodman. Take place in Chicago on Wednesday night. O'Neal. Fouled by Rodman. So Shaquille back to the line where he is 1 for 7.
Now, for one of the rare times after a shot going up, the Chicago Bulls defense falling asleep and everybody turning and watching, and Shaquille quick to the ball right there. But right now the Magic are coming down exclusively here in this fourth quarter, down by 11 and almost going into Shaq every time.
Matt, not that Shaquille's been. And a foul is called. Rodman hit by O'Neal. I would think there are many questions that can be raised.
Well, I can't see the Orlando Magic making any kind of drastic changes, as we see Dennis Rodman getting sandwiched in there, knocked hard to the floor. They do have two big signings coming up, one with
8 points, and the Bulls lead 84-64, and they will go up 3 games to nothing in this best of 7. Hardaway hitting a three. Hardaway has 18. Chicago able to do the job against Shaquille O'Neal. Only 17 points for Shaquille. Oh, look out. O'Neal accidentally, I think, caught Rodman side of the head. Fourth foul by Shaquille. But a stunning 1 of 9 at the line. I say stunning even for Shaquille with all his problems at the free throw line. Bulls have now outscored the Magic 21-10. Final seconds. Hardaway for three. And that will wrap it.
That's how Orlando got an 18-point lead.
O'Neal. O'Neal banking his way and hitting. He's in Chicago on Wednesday night.
Out and challenge Jordan's shot.
And that was called a non-shooting foul. Jordan able to deflect it to the backcourt. No signs of the ankle problem. O'Neal gets inside, and Rodman able to box out for the rebound.
Good defense.
Scott for three. And Longley gets to it. Rodman has been saying, well, O'Neal will be a great player someday. Nice move to the hole. And that is team foul number 4. On the Bulls, Orlando with 3.
Well, Penny Hardaway, who has averaged just 3 assists a game in the 3 games played so far, already has 3 today.
Picked it up offensively. They do not mind seeing Rodman take those kind of shots. He'll set the pick. Scott, including Pippen. Scott.
Good.
Played by Kerr. Oh, nice fake by O'Neal. And he is fouled. Shaquille has certainly had his way in the first half against Dennis Rodman, who in this series has done a terrific job, not only on the court physically, but you get the idea he has gotten into the head of Shaquille O'Neal. That foul, though, is called on Tony Kukoc.
Well, because there is so little double teaming of Shaq, these defenders have to play him straight up. Normally,
with pressure defense here in the first half. Scott with the save. And back comes Kukoc. Dennis Rodman and Shaquille O'Neal. Rodman has certainly done an effective job defending against Shaquille. We asked Shaq about the matchup.
I think Dennis knows that he can't play me one-on-one. I mean, the rules is one arm. An arm has to be halfway. I mean, he puts two hands in the back and a knee in the crotch. He still can't hold me. So, I mean, but this is not a Dennis Rodman Shaq thing. And I'm gonna just go out and play my game. And I only speak when I'm spoken to. And I'm gonna just go out and play.
Well, nobody can really hold Shaq, but Dennis Rodman is averaging 16 rebounds a game so far in the series, and an unexpected 12 points a game so far shut out from the field.
Magic 36 and the Bulls 30 with 3 minutes gone by in the second quarter. Beautiful move. Hopper on the penetration. Rodman with the rebound. And a loose ball foul called on the Magic.
To the floor. Instead of challenging that shot, Shaquille O'Neal got all tangled up with Dennis Rodman and called for the elbow in the throat.
So Shaquille with 2 fouls. O'Neal tried to save it and stepped out. And gets a very sincere pat from Dennis Rodman.
Well, Shaq actually took his eye off the ball here and missed it completely, bouncing off his chest and trying to save it. And throwing it as hard as he could off Dennis Rodman. I'm sure if he had the opportunity again, he'd throw it even higher if he could.
Minute and a half in the first half. Oh, look out. Rodman and O'Neal, and O'Neal with a shove on Rodman. Let's see how the officials handle this one. Dennis Rodman in a conversation with several members of the Orlando Magic. This one was brewing right throughout.
Yeah, Dennis has been starting. Now he's milling around, got into a little verbal altercation with Brian Hill, and they continue to jaw at one another. As there's been some hard hitting there, the shove by Shaquille O'Neal, and Brian Hill walking out towards Dennis Rodman. Richie Adubato protecting Brian. How good that's going to be right now. But so this, when you're a teammate of Dennis Rodman or a Chicago fan, this is what you always worry about with Dennis Rodman, the fireworks starting. You just don't know what's going to go off.
Double technical called on Rodman and O'Neal. O'Neal, who was fouled. The first call. He's 5 of 5 at the line.
Well, Shaq hit him 1, 2, 3 hard times, and Dennis Rodman just trying to grab onto Shaq and maybe instigate a little bit with the grab, and he did what he wanted to do. He got Shaq to react with a push.
So difficult to figure out Shaquille O'Neal's. Is down to 6. 1.5 minutes gone by in the third. Nice push by O'Neal.
The likes to throw the alley-oop lob. Doesn't get an opportunity here. There's the hard spin again.
Yes, and it counts. 4. Bushler has 6 on a couple of three-pointers. O'Neal, this time doing it against James Edwards. Thompson played very tightly by Kerr. O'Neal, Thompson, shot clock at 7. The pass from Hardaway overthrown. And again a travel.
A little bit different. It looks like a walk, and they usually are right in many cases. They were right that time, wrong the play before.
Third travel on Michael Jordan. There's another traveling violation. It's called on Penny Hardaway. To hold on. Scott. He was looking for the 3, could not get it off. Scott off the dribble. Rebounded by Rodman.
Oh!
Rodman over Pippen. And the Bulls are within 2 points.
Now Shaq did not sprint back on defense. Maybe a little leg weary right now. Dennis Rodman did run hard. And even though it was a slow-looking break, Pippen found Rodman all alone underneath.
6-0 run by the Bulls. Backdoor pass broken up by Kerr. Kerr beating Thompson to the cup. That is number 4.
Well, Rodman knew that Shaquille O'Neal was left in his dust all the way into the backcourt. Just ran right down the middle of the floor, right to the front of the rim. And nobody protecting there as Penny Hardaway not able to help.
In Detroit. And you had the mentality to just go out there and kick someone's ass. Seriously, just hit, you know, your butt is ours. Here it's like, we can do it either way. We can do it physically, we can do it mentally. It doesn't matter, we're gonna do it. If we got the right stuff, we're gonna do it.
For the third straight season. Shaquille O'Neal had the good start. However, in the second half, as we have discussed, similar to Penny Hardaway, did not come up big. Shaq finishes with 28, and his offseason has begun, as has Penny Hardaway's. Hardaway finishes
the game today. Offensive-minded, how come you became so offensive-minded in this entire series?
Well, I don't know. You know, I'm looking for a shot, even though I miss it, that means I'm aggressive. I'm a force downer no matter what, but like they say, no matter how big he is,
he can fall just as easy.
How much did the team need your enthusiasm? It seemed as though they were lackadaisical in the beginning of three or four of these games, and you lifted the team significantly today. How much did they need your enthusiasm?
Well, the coach always says, go out there and give us a spark, give us something. And, you know, I said it back in my mind, I got to do something. I have to do. That's my job. I go out there and get a team a lift, and, you know, when you got guys, a group of guys like this playing their asses off, hey, you got to give them credit.
Are you surprised, Dennis, now that this season, as you head to the finals, how well you've been accepted by the Bulls?
Well, I think that they realize that they see a hardworking man when they see one. And hopefully I get to stay here a couple more years. If not, it's been fun. It's been great. And let's go do it.
All right. Congratulations to you, Dennis.
Thanks a lot. Hi, Alexis.
Shaquille, I'm going to present you with your new jersey and also a hat.
Photographers now asking Shaquille O'Neal to pose with his new jersey.
Whom obviously enjoys the Hollywood scene. He's got a movie.
I just want to, you know, thank you all for coming out. And in case you haven't figured it out yet, I've signed with the Los Angeles Lakers. And keep in mind the word change. To me, change is for the good. And before we get started, I would like to thank Rich DeVos and the Orlando Magic for helping my dream come true in 1992 when they drafted me. They have a beautiful organization. They have a great organization. Good, fair deal. But no, money was not the main factor here. And, you know, I think, you know, people get, you know, tired of hearing money. I just want to go, have fun, be young, drink Pepsi, wear Reebok, and have fun.
Well, it was something. It lived up to the promise, did it not? We have reached halftime. And in 9 minutes, allowed 8 points. Parrish 4 minutes, 9 points. Simpkins and Rodman And what would you expect now?
Quarter, his tight quarter. All right, Rodman has got his hair combed and ready to go. Pass out in front, ball into Shaq. Shaq backing in on Winnington. Stern, shoot an 8 foot.
He definitely turned it over.
Van Exel takes the ball in low to Shaq. Shaq turned, 15 footer at the base. That's what I talked to him at halftime about. Nice play. Van Exel didn't get any help from teammates back there. All right, Van Exel with it live under the Shaq. It's off his hands. It'll go to Kukoc. Kukoc in the front court. Pretty good defensive job by Rodman on that play.
The ball
comes in deep, beats everybody, throws it over to Kersey. Kersey's 20-footer on the way. That's in and out and stays out. Rebound is out. Volleyball to the sideline. Last touch by the Lakers. Yep. Sometimes I guess he had no choice. Jones takes it in low to Shaq. He's against Rodman. Bounce out in front to Van Exel. Dribble drive in deep. He ought to make that one. He blew it. Rodman's got the rebound.
A real good floor.
Nobody
game.
Said he wasn't.
Real
just
good
reporting
game.
The game. He made a bad pass. The ball goes in low to Shaq. Shaq holds it up to be double teamed. Out in front to Scott. To Jones. The three-pointer won't be close. Hit the bottom of the backboard.
Nice total so far tonight. He's got 27 points and 9 rebounds. He's made 12 out of 18 from the field. 23 of those 27 in the first half.
Throws the ball all the way to the baseline in the corner to Shaq. Boy, that pass has to be accurate. Shaq driving, comes in deep. Did he travel? No. Did he get fouled? No. Rebound is up. It goes to Chicago. The Lakers need a hoop so badly. Into Shaq, who has only 2 field goals in the second half. To Van Exel. Van Exel gets the screen. 10 on the 24. Into Shaq. Here's the double team. Out to Jones. He's down the middle. He's in deep. He's all the way to score. 5:53 to play. It's nervous time at United Center in the Windy City. Ball into Shaq. He's due for a basket. He comes in deep and gives to Kersey. 20-footer by the veteran. Not close. Rebound is off. Rodman's got it. Rodman in the rebound department now has 13. You know what? Defense. Lakers lead it by just 8. That's the closest Chicago's been. Van Exel throws it out of bounds.
Oh, wow. They got mixed up there.
Just 2:54 remaining in regulation play. And Dell Harris doing a little teaching in that Los Angeles Laker huddle to these young guys. Shaquille O'Neal in the fourth quarter, no points, no field goals attempt, no free throws, no rebounds.
Well, I tell you what, the no rebounds are surprising and the no free throw attempt. After this game, Dell Harris will go up to Shaquille and say, you know what, you were great tonight in the fourth quarter and you didn't even score.
Van Exel on the front court, cross court pass to Campbell, 2:35 to play. Shaq's only got 2 baskets and a half. Pass knocked away and out of bounds by Jordan.
Chick,
7 seconds left.
One of the pro.
High Jones has got it. He's going to have trouble getting it in. Bad pass. Horrible pass. Foul is on Shaq. 2 free throws coming.
Rodman with the steal. Pippen with the shot.
Yeah, and great defense by the Bulls. Smart foul. Smart foul by Shaquille O'Neal. Another guy who's not a great free throw shooter that no one talks about is Scottie Pippen.
60% for the season, 3 of 4.
Pass didn't have much on it, but it got there. Fisher bounced the baseline to Shaq, out in front of Van Exel. Van Exel takes it. Fisher for 3, won't get there. Shaq's rebound. Shaq shoots a 10-footer and misses. Campbell's rebound. They foul Campbell. Here comes Jones. Here's a pass baseline. Fisher comes underneath, puts it up. They say it was blocked. Blocked by Rodman.
Why did you shoot it that fast?
Coming with the ball. I don't know. Score this time or lose the ball game, in my opinion, Stu. Van Exel with it. Wants to go into Shaq. Van Exel down the middle. Throws it up. It banks in. Shaquille O'Neal has not scored a point since very early in the third quarter. He's got 27. Maybe this is his time. The front court. Van Exel yo-yoing up and down, probably glad that there's no pressurizing the ball in the front court. Now the ball to Shaq. Shaq throws it away. Here we go. Pippen's got it. Give to Brown. Brown under to Jordan. He puts it up and missed it. Jordan missed the shot.
He probably didn't see Michael, but it would have been a great time right off this steal to give Michael the bucket.
Shot no good. Rebound to Campbell. Shot no good. Rebound to Shaq. 4 minutes to play. This is the strangest game, one in certain spots that you'll ever see. Ball into Shaq, 15 on the clock, out to Kersey. Kersey's really shooting and not connecting. Rebound to George. First time that they've left. Van Exel with it, minute and a half to play. Van Exel gives the ball to Shaq. He's fouled hard.
That should be flagrant. That should be flagrant.
If it's flagrant, it'll come out of bounds plus the two shots. I don't think they're going to call it flagrant.
Well, they grabbed him around the head. I mean, how can that not be flagrant? And they're not calling flagrant. I don't believe that. They're saying that he played the ball.
Who'd they give the foul to?
Rodman. They give the foul to Rodman, pick and roll. Shaq goes to the basket, and I mean, they grab him butt good. The way the rule states,
in and out. Missed them both. Rebound is off to Rodman. Oh, he scored every Laker point in the overtime, Van Exel. Van Exel stops outside. Three-pointer is straight. In and out. Rebound hit by Campbell out to Jones. Three-pointer. No good again. Rebound is up. Timeout is called by Rodman. Oh, that stupid Rodman. His teammates wrestle him to the floor. And Jordan picks him up by his jersey. Said, you want to cost us the ball game? Boy, he could have cost his team the game. He got kicked out of the game? I don't think so.
No.
Follow him. And now the Bulls maybe will take him out and take that threat away.
Well, that young fellow we saw was very angry at
him. Yeah. Seconds, we'll call it, left in the overtime.
Well, the Lakers missed a shot. Dennis Rodman gets the rebound, calls timeout. Kersey tries to take the ball, and then that's when the tempers flared just a little bit. Scottie Pippen and Michael Jordan were making sure that Dennis Rodman was not going to get in a situation that cost his team a ball game as they wrestled him to the floor as Dennis comes up laughing. He's all show. I'm telling you, he has really marketed himself as far as a wild man, so to speak. Shaq came over, wanted to have a piece of Dennis as well. Well, he hadn't scored tonight, but he got 16 rebounds. That's about what he averages on the season, and that's what he's out there for, rebounding and defense. And now with only 20 seconds to play, the Lakers are in a situation where they have to go for a steal.
Ticket for that one, forget it. The free throw by Rodman is his only point of the game. Give yourself a hand, Dennis. One, ball to Bryant, he fires from distance, hit the rim, comes down to Rodman. Rodman throws it up into the air, and when it comes down, the game will be over. It is over. Wow. 129-123. The final score.
Well, Dennis, obviously you're down 22 points, and you guys never gave up. At what point did you look in their eyes and say, hey, we can win this thing?
I don't know what to say. It's amazing. It's kind of emotional where you see these guys. We never gave up. And you see in the fourth quarter, we didn't get calls. We didn't get anything. But Tony Kukoc came up big tonight, big time.
35 points for Scottie Pippen, also 3 points on the souffle when he and Jordan took you down to the sideline.
That's what basketball is all about. People like to see stuff like that, a little activity, a little here and there. I mean, but that's the way it should be, you know. Don't contain it, so just let them go. Let them be wild and free, baby.
A very emotional week for you with the suspension, but did you have fun tonight? You said you were bored earlier. Was this what it's all about?
I had a great time. This kind of games I like to get up for and hope for the rest of the season will be like this. And you can't say enough about this team. We're an old team, but we're a very veteran and wise and crafty team, and people should not count us out.
Great rebounding. Terrific job on Shaq defensively in the second quarter. And nice free throws at the end.
Oh, yeah. You know, Shaq only had, 6 points in the second half or something like that. You know, people said that Dennis Rodman is this, Dennis Rodman is that. But they can't deny, but he's a hell of a basketball player.
Yes, he is. Thanks a lot, Dennis. Let's go back to Vern.
Ori, J.
to O'Neal. And he gets Ostertag with his second block tonight. Here comes Stockton. 3-on-1 to Malone. Sec. Nice feed to an open car. What a pass to Malone. What a...
Malone and Shaq. Good matchup.
But Utah in overtime prevails 98-93, and the Utah Jazz going to the Western Conference Finals.
The Jazz deserve the goal. They're the team with the best record in the Western Conference. You don't win 64 games without being a very good team.
Malone right now has scored 17 points, but they've all come against Luke Longley. He's got to get some confidence against Rodman.
Isley looking for help. Here's Malone just beating the shot clock and missing. Further in the fourth, Malone rattles in and out on it. Comes out and screens high, then gets it back and misses the jumper.
Malone has got to throw that bulk around and said, right now it's my time to lead my team to a win tonight and even this series up.
But don't be surprised if Dennis Rodman steps up to the line and knocks these free throws down, because that's the kind of guy that he is. Under pressure, he loves the pressure and he loves this time of the game. And it wouldn't surprise if he walked up there and made one of them.
Well, the gods were with him on that.
You think he was in Las Vegas with that bounce. I thought that's only when he was in Utah that he went to Vegas. What a bounce he got there.
He rolls the dice again and makes them both.
A little bit more than everybody else right now.
They call it on Malone for pulling him down. Now Rodman, with two a moment ago, hits another one. Off the court, his tired freak show continues, but on the court, he brings unique talents, tremendous energy and heart. And if they win in the third row, he's been...
How have you managed to shut Karl Malone down again? You just held him to one basket there, and it was right there at the end in the fourth quarter.
That's what I just said. I can't believe out of all basket in the world, he shoot this three. And, you know, I think I just, like I said, I'm more mobile. My agility is a lot better than Luke Longley. He can do anything he wants on Luke, but against me, he can't, because I got too much heart for him to beat me down there.
You going wrestling tomorrow?
I'm not wrestling tomorrow. I'm going to go out and have a...
Have a good time.
All right,
let's go over to...
Rodman shoots from the head of the key and connects. Even he has to say, hey, go figure.
Now, Chicago has been in...
Now, you watch Rodman here. Now, Rodman's a pretty good straight-on shooter when he gets himself set. He can knock this shot down. Doesn't take it a lot, but you look at the rotation and the form on the basketball... Doesn't shoot him much, but he says, thank you right there.
4.5 minutes of the quarter, the only field goal belongs to Rodman on a 20-foot jumper. Rodman drills a 20-footer and gives it that go figure gesture.
Now remember, in game two in here, he hit that same shot to tie the game. This one brings him to within one.
4:46 left. If he hits this, he can tie it.
Duncan against Rodman.
Over the top.
Duncan. An air ball. Yep. To Robinson up high. There's the high-low pass down to the rookie, and it's deflected away. Tim Duncan against Dennis Rodman. Michael Jordan tried to double down.
We got some...
Duncan's pass deflected by Pippen.
Tony is now... Well, here Rodman has picked up David.
Forces Robinson to go baseline. Field goal percentage. Robinson in close and Rodman Pippen over to help. Game, seventh in the NBA. Duncan...
Offensive foul, yes sir.
Vinny Del Negro, Robinson against Rodman. Joe Klein comes over to Moore. Call 312-455-4226 for more information. Pass from Robinson off the mark behind.
Rebound, he misses the tip. Now watch the ball as it's going out of bounds. Look at this. What a save, he saved.
Has two assists in the entire series. Duncan with the hook, and that's the way game four starts. Elliott. Duncan off the glass. Sean Elliott around a Duncan screen, returns it to him for the jumper.
It's three straight turnovers, basically. Look at this, the position Duncan gets. And Shaq has got to do a better job of taking that space away.
Here for Shaquille O'Neal. These figures are worth noting. He's in his seventh year in the league, and he hasn't won an NBA title. Well, you could say the same thing of Jerry West, Elgin Baylor, Wilt Chamberlain, but the difference is that they were always close. They were pushing Russell's Celtics to the seventh game, it seemed, every year, and having their hearts broken. When Shaq's teams, be they the Magic or the Lakers, have left, they've gone out with a whimper. Look how it's ended. In one case, in 95, it was the NBA Finals against Hakeem and the Rockets. But nonetheless, in the closing series now of his career, assuming they lose this game, Shaquille O'Neal's teams will be 1-23.
Now he stumbles backwards. That's when he gets stripped. He's up so much time getting the ball to the court. That might be the reason why they've gotten away from the triangle. Takes a little more time.
San Antonio lead. Duncan try to go blast and not have the...
Duncan has to stay home.
Malone gets in. Duncan gets doubled and George with the steal now. Inside to Duncan over Malone.
Too quick.
Duncan.
Yep, he traveled.
And he traveled, yep.
Karl Malone once again has pulled the chair and made Duncan lose his balance. He's done it at least once again.
Yeah.
So difficult to block some.